Hey guys, it's 3 a.m. After my surgery day, and I'm finally gonna have a meal. I don't think I can chew, and I don't want to chew, so I'm really glad I bought a meal drink, so yay passed to me. And after 30 minutes, I'm gonna have my medication. I actually barfed 3 times. And that was terrible. Twice at the clinic because I was really nauseous and dizzy, and then once on the drive back to the hotel. And honestly, this doesn't hurt. I know it looks like it, and I know like a lot of like YouTubers who and influencers who get surgery, they're like, oh yeah, this honestly doesn't hurt. It really doesn't. For now, I don't know if there's still some anesthesia in me, but my chin is the part that hurts the most. And since I was throwing up so much, this hurt the most. Yeah. And actually, I also barfed once when we were in between surgeries. So that was like, yeah, I hate throwing up. My nose doesn't hurt that much, but after I threw up, it hurt a little bit more and it stings a little. So, yeah, I don't know. Yeah. Ooh. So, honestly, the part that hurt the most though was prepping for the surgery, and that I wanted to quit. I want to be like, fuck this. I just wanted to walk out and be like, no. That was the worst. I hated the prepping part. And I don't know how anyone really gets addicted to surgery, especially when, like, I'm sure the recovery process is gonna be even more painful, but yeah. People who get addicted to surgery, how do you be okay with the prepping part all the time? It's so painful. Anyways, I'm gonna have this now because I haven't had anything in my tummy since like 8 a.m. yesterday before my surgery, so yeah. Sorry guys, I am naked and I cannot be bothered to put any clothes on, and if there's a nip slip, well, I guess I'm getting banned off of YouTube, but yeah, so okay, yeah, so it just looks like this. Oh shit, my nose, it's let me go clean it up. I wonder if there's a particular reason why my right nostril is like this. And my left one is just like, meh. Yeah, the only other thing that really hurts is my chin. And oh, because I threw up, you know, a little bit of the throw kind of like went on my bandages. So that's kind of like, what the hell? So yeah. Anyways, back to the drink. Yeah, so it's just like a smoothie and it's pretty good. Oh, and also once I came back, I was just like, I don't care about anything, and I just took everything off and didn't even bother like putting it back in place. I just went to bed. I tried eating, but I was still so nauseous that even like a delicious jelly drink, I was gonna throw up. So I was just like, you know what, I'm just gonna freaking lay down and I'll think about eating later, which is funny because I love food and eating. Yeah, definitely. Oh, so much better. that nut was really, really nice to have. I really wanted to nap at the clinic, but and I was like, can I stay overnight? And they said no. And I was like, okay, I guess I'll go home or go back to my hotel. Oh, it's like crusty. Oh shit, should I even attempt? I can't tell if it's focusing, I'm sorry guys. Quality content right here. Yeah. Okay. I feel like I shouldn't be picking at this. I actually had another bandage that went across my face. I don't know if you guys saw it in the last clip. Or like post-surgery. But yeah, that one was a little funny. Wait, sorry, no, not funny. That one was like, it helped a lot with the bleeding. Because it was just basically a little mini towel absorbing all the blood. You know, this camera, why is it not focusing, please? I'm trying to make a video here. Anyways, I'm gonna finish my drink and yeah. Okay, there's a mirror, a really big mirror above here. I'll try not to get a titty shot in, but these are some recovery items that they gave me right after my surgery. These are pills that I have to take. And then this is Fusiden, apparently. And then a bunch of sticks. That I know, they're cotton swabs. And then some instructions on like what not to do and, you know, more details about post-surgery and, you know, when they're gonna remove my bandages and which days I'm gonna go see them. And then this is a liquid that I'm supposed to gargle after I eat. So yeah, I have to eat all of these. Wow. Here we go again. Ooh, right. They took cartilage from my ear. Should not have done that. Okay, gonna go back to my drink. I'm getting distracted. Good morning! So, I am having some water jelly. And I think this is like yogurt. Yeah. For breakfast. So, since I was awake, I didn't really go back to sleep. I was just sort of like catching up with some friends back in NA, and yeah. I feel like with just a couple of hours, I feel like it looks a little bit more swollen. So I will be able to take out my cotton rolls 24 hours after my surgery. So I have about another 12 hours until I can take them out. And yeah, actually it's a little bit hard to suck. But oh damn, this is so good. I should get more of this. Just cause I the chin implant. Why is this happening to me? Just stay on, please. I also don't have any like face masks cause I do need to go out and get some more meal drinks and jelly, and I kind of want cheese string cheese. Yeah, so it kind of hurts just because my incision is right here, and it when I'm like sucking the cotton rolls, they kind of move back a little bit because, well, I'm not gonna go to the technicals about sucking stuff, so yeah. It just hurts a little bit. I don't know if I should probably stop sucking. Yeah. There's a lot of drool though, so. Hello! So, it's almost been about 24 hours since I've came out of surgery. Another 3 hours, so yeah. I finished my surgery at 8 p.m. apparently. I don't know, I was all doped up, but you know, that's what they said. And, yeah, so I removed the gauze out of my right nostril. And, yeah, I wasn't sure if my left nostril had a gauze, because, I don't know, I wasn't breathing through my nose, and then suddenly I was breathing through my nose, and I was like, huh, I can breathe through my left nostril. But, like, since the beginning, I was already breathing through my mouth, because that's what they told me to do once I came out of surgery. And then I just thought that my right nostril was just bleeding a lot more, and my left nostril wasn't bleeding at all. So I don't really know if I had like a left nostril gauze, but yeah, I think, you know, this side will kind of calm down a little bit, and then the holes will be even. So I feel a lot comfortable now since I've taken out the gauze. Oh my god, what a difference. Anyways, I applied some of the Fusidin on the incision area, and then yeah, just cleaned up a little bit. I also had a tape bandage thing here, but that was like falling off my face, so I just decided to rip it off. It kept, because my hair was kind of like all over the place, it kept getting stuck onto it, and then the tape lost its adhesive, and yeah. So, took it off, so hopefully that's okay. And then, yeah, I'm gonna try to gently try to remove this, because I ran out of food. Well, I ran out of my drinks. Speaking of the drinks, you know that very yummy strawberry yogurt jelly? Yeah, so that has the type of milk that I can't have, and I was kind of like having diarrhea. My tummy really hurts, and also because there was so much drainage from the gauze, I mean in my nose, like the blood, like I kept ingesting like the blood and everything, that like my tummy really 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 hurts. And the whole day pretty much I kind of been having like like bubble guts, I guess. Like it keeps going like blip 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 blip. But yeah. My liposuction areas are getting a little bit more sore. So I was explaining this to my friend. It kind of just feels like when you haven't worked out for a long time and then suddenly you go do Muay Thai for 2 hours, like intense Muay Thai. That's what it feels like. Like you haven't worked out in ages and you finally workout and you're so sore and everything's sore. So yeah, my lower, my abdomen area is sore, my arms are sore, so it makes it a little bit hard to I guess get around. So I'm kind of wondering how I'm gonna go out and buy food. So I'm kind of getting over the fact that I'm gonna freak people out. So yeah, so now the new challenge is getting on clothes. Because I do have a bunch of like bandages and wraps and like styrofoam on, like, not styrofoam, just foam on my abdomen area. But yeah, I think I'll figure something out. I would show you, but I'm naked. yeah. Oh my god, I always wondered, like, you know, like every person that gets surgery, like, everyone looks the same after surgery because they're just swollen. And, like, it's so funny that I also look just swollen. I don't know. It's weird to me. Also, actually, my right leg is, or, like, my foot ankle is actually a bit swollen. And it was really, really painful earlier. Sorry. Having blood and snot come out of my nose. But, yeah, it was really swollen, and not like super swollen, but like I could feel it, and it was like having pain, and I was like, oh, it hurts. But I messaged the kind girl, Julia, who works at the clinic, And she said it's normal and it should go away in 2-3 days. So, you know, I just have to suck it up. But, yeah. I'll update you on my food adventure. But, yeah, so far, nothing really hurts much. Still, there's, like, tension on the chin area. Especially when I suck. Can't really smile. It hurts. And then here, actually, I'm starting to get a little bit of pain when I, like, try to be a little bit more expressive with my face. Which, you know, usually I'm very expressive with my face. All the derp faces. But, yeah. But so far, first 24 hours-ish is not too bad. I think the most painful thing is just my foot, really. I really don't like having any pain in my foot. So that part sucks, and just have to be a little bit more careful and strategic when I'm moving around because of my arm. Because of my liposuctioned areas, those areas are quite sore. So yeah, I'll keep you updated. Hello, it is a little bit past 7:30. And look, more water jelly and meal drinks and some string cheese. I didn't pick it up. The kind people at Persona, they asked how I was, and I was like, oh, I'm trying to, you know, attempt to go out, and they're like, oh, no. Stay where you are, we'll help you grab whatever you need. And then, yeah, they just came by. And, yeah, gave me these. Also got me nachos. Nacho chips, which I don't think I can eat. Because the powder and the opening of my incision. And then, 4 of these. So, yeah, I just ended up wearing the robe. That the hotel gives you, and yeah, just waddled my way downstairs. I think I scared him. Oops. But yeah, gonna have some jelly and then have some more mints because I'm starting to feel a little bit more pain. So I guess that's a sign that the pain meds are wearing off and I need to take them soon. So yeah, my nose is still bleeding a bit, but should be okay. Yeah, one big, one small. I'm sure it's not gonna be like this. It's still just like the first day. It still hasn't been 24 hours since I've had the surgery, so you know, I'm sure things will change. Things will swell down and reshape, so yeah. Just a lot of bleeding. I just wish the bleeding would stop because it's really annoying to just waste so many tissues. Okay, so actually, this is peach flavored. 5 calories per, wow. How to slim down in Korea. I actually think I'm gonna lose a lot of weight doing this because I can't chew, right? So, well, okay, I probably can, but I prefer not to chew right now, so I probably shouldn't touch my ear. This is the ear that I got the cartilage removed from, and I accidentally touched it yesterday, and I was like, oh my god, so painful. This is mango flavored. I'm just gonna put it in the fridge so it cools down. The food he picked up from the grocery, I mean the convenience store, is cold. So, apple and peach. I have those. Oh, actually, I have a meal drink too. So, maybe just apple and a meal drink. Yeah, so because it's a little bit hard to chew, I kind of like, I'm just kind of drinking, having like easy to consume types of food. And I also, because I need a gargle every time I eat, I have to gargle with half a cup of water and then this solution and then another half cup of water. I know it's just gargling, but because of the surgery I got, the chin implant, it's really painful. Or I can't even gargle. It's just I suck it and then it just runs out of my mouth, and it's so I don't know, it's annoying to do. But yeah. Oh yeah, and all this string cheese. Haha, he got me so many. Low moisture, hard skinned mozzarella. I will have one. A little bit of protein. I actually had these the other day when I was here before my surgery, and they were so good. And you know, it didn't give me diarrhea or anything, which was great. So, yeah. Am I bleeding? I think so. It's kind of scary that I'm talking without moving my lips. I'm freaking myself out. I don't know how you guys feel, but yeah. Okay, so food time and then meds. And then this is my pile of bloody snot and tissue. So my left nostril is, I'm having a lot of regular clear snot, and then this side I'm just having blood come out, and it's no, I don't know, man. It's so annoying, I'm using so many tissues. But yeah, I was because my arms are sore, right? And my abdomen is sore, I'm sort of trying to do weird lunges. I don't know, just trying to move my body. It hasn't even been 24 hours, but I'm trying really hard to just move a little bit more. And yeah, so, okay. Really gotta eat because I really need to take my meds. So I wanna try these. Maybe when I'm healed.